Okay, so we're going to talk about the partner co-compensation plan. There are actually 9 ways that you get paid. I'm going to go through each one of them very rapidly. So first one is retail profits. This is pretty simple because it is based on how much you pay for your product and how much the customer pays. So if the retail price is $100 and you pay $70, then you make the difference between the 100 and the 70, so in this example, $30. So that's retail profits, simple. Second way to get paid into the new volume business bonus. And how it works is basically it's based on the PV. PV is point value. Each product is assigned a point value, and this is what the whole compensation plan is based on for the next bonuses and commissions that you're gonna see in the next few slides. But basically, the point volume is what our international currency is represented by the PV. This allows us to have the same way to get paid around the world. So if a product sells in dollars here, but in euros, of course, in Europe, then you get paid on the PV of that product, not the euros, not the dollars. All right, so it's very simple to calculate around the world. All right, so the new business volume, so the way it works is basically, when you join the business, you can start and decide which level you're gonna start at. And this is based on how much volume you produce in your first 4 weeks or first 4 Fridays in the business. So when you join, if you generate 200 PV from personal purchases or those of your customers, and it can be you or your customers or both combined, okay? So the computer system is gonna look over the next 4 Fridays how much volume you produce, your customers and yourself, and if it's 200 PV, you're at the activated level. If it's 500, you're at the business level. If it's elite, you're at 1,000 points, you're at the elite level, and at 1,500, you're at the ultimate level, all right? What does that make for you as a difference? Well, one of the differences is how much you earn on that first volume of new people that you enroll in the business and as customers. So if a customer purchases for, let's say, 100 PV, and you are at the activated level because in your first 4 Fridays, you generate 200 points. So that means on that first volume that that customer generates, you get 15%, $15. Now, if you actually were at the ultimate level because in your first 4 Fridays, you generate 1,500 point volume, then you are at 30%. So 30% of 100, that will be $30. So it's double, right? Now, the only exception to this is if one of your customers or brand partners generates more than your level. So in this example, let's say you are at the activated level, and the person who joins in their first 4 Fridays, there's one of those weeks, one of those first 4 weeks, that they generate, let's say, 1,000 points from a purchase. Then in this case, they would bump you for that specific time at 25%. The rest of the time, you'd always be at 15%, all right? So that's how the comp plan works when you start. Now, the other benefit that it has, which is quite significant, is when you start, if you're at the activated level, you have 2 lines that you can start to build. So you have one, let's say this one and this one, all right? If you want to have more lines that you want to build, you can, but you have to wait until you optimize those 2. And optimization means 13,334 point volume in that line and the same in the second line. When you do that for the first time, the company gives you a new pay line that you can start to build. When you optimize this one at 13,334 PV in that whole group in 1 week, they give you a 4th line. And so you can do that, you can expand your business as you want. Now the difference is, if you want to build 3, 4, or 5 lines right from the get-go, you can do that, but you need to be an ultimate, right? This gives you 5 lines to start with. So it's really a personal choice. You decide however you want to build it. Okay, let's go to the next one. Base commissions, this is the centerpiece of our compensation plan. And you're gonna see that most people, this is where they start to earn enough money to go from part-time to full-time, right? As you start to build a team, you have the option to build an organization And so you are here. You bring in two brand partners, people who are like you, who want to start and build their own business. And they have their own customers, and they also have brand partners. And those brand partners bring in more. So those teams grow in volume. Let's say this one does 2,000 points of volume. And line number two, let's say here, does 1,000 points of volume. Now, the compensation plan on the base commission would earn you 15% of the pay lines. So there could be more pay lines, right? But let's say in this example, there's only two lines. So which one is the power line? Which one is the pay line? The one with the most volume is considered the power line. And the other ones are the pay lines. So for here, we have 1,000 point volume, 15% of that, that's $100 in, you know, $150 in commissions. So what the system does at the end of the week is they deduct from both lines 1,000 because that's the money they paid you on. All right, so they paid you on 1,000 points. So they deduct it from the pay line, 1,000. So there's zero left. But on the power line, 2,000 minus 1,000, there's 1,000 carry over. So that means when you start the new week, you already have 1,000 points in this line. And every volume that adds up, it will add up here. And this one starts at zero because you got paid on it. All right, so that's how this worked. Now, the other thing to consider also is that in this compensation plan, you can have multiple pay lines, right? And so for this example, we have, let's say the first one is also the power line, again this time. The second line is 1,000 points, and the third one has 1,500 points. So you would get paid on these two lines right here, right? So $370, $375. But the difference here is that because there's 1,000 plus, 1,000 plus 2,500, all right, 1,000 plus 1,500, what happens is now there's 2,500 to deduct from the power line. Does that put you in the hole of 500? No, the company just puts the power line back to zero. That's it. It's pretty simple. Okay, now when you optimize for the first time two of your lines, so the power line and a pay line, what the company will do is they will actually, and optimization is 13,334 points, and the same here, okay? So when that happens, the company does two things. They give you a new income position right here that you can see, a new re-entry that you can place down below in one of your pay lines. You choose which one. If you have only one, you place it there. But if you have multiple pay lines, you can place that re-entry in one of your, you know, under one of your pay lines, somewhere you decide where you want this. Now, why would you want to do this? Because sometimes maybe there's someone in that line that you'd like to team up with and really work, maybe opening a new market, you know, things like that. But let's say if that line is already optimized, why would you build there? Well, if you put a new re-entry, a new income position, then you can start to build with them that new position. You'll have a power line and a pay line to build, and you can do that. The same thing as if you had just joined. Right, but now you rejoined below your own team. So it gives you that, and it gives you also a new pay line. So you can build both or one or the other. It's your choice. Right? And so your re-entry, you can place it later. You don't have to place it right away. You can wait. Whenever you're ready, you call customer service and you ask them to place your new income position in your team. As far as the new pay line, you can build it whenever you want. All right, but you have those two. And once you optimize this one, they give you a new re-entry, so a second one, and they give you a new pay line. And that can go on forever, okay? So you can build your business as wide and as deep as you want. Now, the other aspect is the auto-balancing feature, which is very, very interesting, especially when you're when you have a lot of customers personally. Then there's volume, there's extra volume that you don't actually need to qualify for your business. So what do they do with that? Well, instead of being at the end of the week and calculating where you should place the volume from your customers, you don't have to worry about any of that. Why? Because the company will automatically look at in your organization through a special algorithm that looks at 8 different criteria and decide where to place the volume so it benefits you the most. And I'm going to give you a personal example that this happened to us many years ago. And so I took a screenshot the before the calculation, because I wanted to see how the system will allocate this extra volume to make sure that they do allocate it in the right spot. All right, and so I don't have anything to do. We just let the system do its job. So if you look at the top here, it shows that there's extra volume of 4,076 points. That's pretty, you know, a lot of extra volume. I'm not sure why it didn't place it here, but that's fine. It was extra volume from customers and personal purchases. So what did the computer do? Well, let me actually show you the structure of our organization at that time. Okay, so we have income position one and we have four lines. In those four lines in line one, we had an income position that we placed here. We had a third income position we placed here, a fourth, a fifth here, and a sixth one here. And so you look here, there's the volume from each one of those lines and income positions back in those days. All right, and so if you look at income position one, line one, that would be this one, there was 6,700 points. All right, the total volume, 6,700 points. Line two had 7,400. Line three was optimized at 13,334. And line four had 1,700. They could have placed that 4,000 right here, but that would have paid us 15% of that one time. So let's say $600 approximately. But the computer still looked in the system and checked if they could reward us even more. So they looked at income position two and they probably guessed that, okay, if we place the volume here, we're going to pay you because that's a pay line, because this one is already more than 4,000, so that would be the power line. So we'll pay you 15%, so that's 600. And that line, the volume under here, rolls up that line. And so that would be line number 1.1. They would also get, you know, would get to pay us 15% extra. So that would be two times $600. And the computer kept looking at that. Do we place it in line 3.2, 4.2, 5? There's actually, yeah, we could place it also here. Or they kept looking at 6.1, 0.2, and they looked here, okay? And what ended up happening is they actually placed the volume right here, as you can see, 6.3. Why? Well, it balanced with this line, all right, because the line 6.1 was more than 4,000, so that became the power line, and this was a pay line. And so we got paid $600 right here. But that volume rose up to position four, but position four doesn't have anything in line two, so there's no line two, okay, three. Three doesn't have line two, it's line one, so there's already volume here. But line two, 2.2, let's look at that. There's already volume here enough. So the 4,000 extra added here, that's another $600 that we got paid on. That whole volume rose up the line to line 1.1 right here. So they added another 4,000. You can see it was at 6,000 here. So they added another 4,000. So we got paid another 600. So we got paid three times 600, which is $1,800 on that 4,000 points of volume, which is pretty amazing. We didn't have anything to do. We just let the computer do its job. And at the end of the week, they calculated everything and we got paid all of this. This is a lot of volume. Okay, savings bonus, how it works. It's a pretty interesting concept because many companies, they have a car program. And what they do with the car is they say, okay, you qualify for the car, go get a lease. Who gets the lease? Yourself, under your name. What if 1 week or 1 month the volume decreases a little bit and you don't qualify for the bonus? Who has to pay for the car? You. Well, they decided to create something different. They call it the savings bonus. What they do is every week they look at how much base commission, so that's the income you make from your pay lines, okay, from your different pay lines. If it's over $250, then what they do is they add an extra 15% of that money into a savings bonus. So they calculate, let's say your base commission was $2,000 this week. They calculate 15% of that extra that they put $300 in your savings bonus. And they accumulate that week after week after week until you reach $10,000. Once you reach $10,000, they send it to you. You do whatever you want with it. You want to buy a car, down payment on a car and a house, or pay off credit cards, or buy a trip. You do whatever you want with it. Now, after you receive your $10,000, what do? Is they keep accumulating the money every week, but for 4 weeks. At the end of 4 weeks, and it's maximum $500 per week, okay? At the end of 4 weeks, they pay it to you. They accumulate another 4 weeks, they pay it to you, all right? Maximum $500 per week. So you could literally make about $2,000 per month extra just from that savings bonus once you receive that $10,000. So that's another great, great, great program. Okay, income position bonus. Here is where, as you build your team and you help the company grow, the company set aside 2% of the worldwide sales into this bonus pool. And what they do is they say, okay, if you would like to build income positions, so that means you have your income position one and you optimize it. Optimization is two lines optimized, 13,334 points each, okay, just like right here, all right? If you do that, that week, you earn shares in the bonus pool. But if you optimize another income position, you get even more shares. So two lines at least at 13,334, then you get more shares into the bonus pool. And if you optimize a third one, you keep getting more shares. Let me show you how many shares you get each time you add a new income position that you optimize. This is how it works. What we found is, on average, it's roughly about $200 per share. That's what it's worth. So if you optimize one income position, you get two shares into the bonus pool. So that would be $400 extra. And that's each week. Each week that you qualify, you get it. Now, if you were to optimize two income positions, they give you not only just two shares, but the second one, they give you four. So it's 2 + 4. So that's a total of 6 shares, $1,200. If you optimize three income positions, they give you 2 + 4 + 6. That's 12 shares. That's 2,400. You can see the multiplication. So that means each time you build a new income position, that new one earns you more than the previous ones. Why is that? Because they realize that as you grow your team and you become a bigger leader, you impact more people. Every time you come and speak on stage or you do a training and you help your team, it grows even more. It has more impact on the company than when you were a smaller leader. And so the company decided to incentivize those leaders and tell them, well, you can retire if you want. You can enjoy life, get your money, you know, take advantage of all of that. Or if you want to build with us a little bit more, we're going to pay you even more this time. So that's a very, you know, wise way to reward people. And as you become a leader, you can create more and more income. Now, some people will say, yeah, that's great, but I don't want to build income positions. I want to build wide. I want to build more pay lines. So the company decided to set aside 1% of the worldwide product PV into that pay line bonus pool. All right. And so instead of, like, when you build, you have your two pay line, like one power line and one pay line. Then if you build a second pay line, that's where you start to earn into the pay line bonus. So let me show you those shares. And again, now this time, the pay line bonus, on average, it's about $250 worth per share. That varies, of course, from 1 week to the next based on the sales of the company, based on how many people qualify into the bonus pool. But that's on the average. That's been about that for the last 11, like several years. Okay, so as you build that one more pay line, you get two shares, that's $500. You get 2 + 4, same concept. You get it? 2 + 4 + 6, and so on. So this becomes a great advantage. And sometimes we look at the pay lines and we say, oh, we only earn $2,000 in base commission. No, in base commission plus pay line bonus plus matching bonuses, which we're going to see in a minute now. All right, so matching bonuses, how it works is this is based on you helping other people on your team make money. The more people make money and the more money they make, the more your income grows. So we get paid actually on 7 generations of matching bonuses. There's some criteria that you need to meet, but what I've seen is as your team grows, you typically meet those criteria. So it really grows based on your income. As the more your income grows, the more you unlock those generations. So on generation one, that means the people that you personally enroll in the business. It doesn't matter where you place them. They can be frontline to you, they can be downline, that you place them down below. It doesn't matter where you place them. In your power line, in your pay line, it doesn't matter. But because you enroll them, they are considered your first generation. You get 15%, so you match 15% of what they earn in base commission from their pay line. So if they earn, let's say you enroll one person and they earn $1,000 from their pay line this week, well, you would make 15% of that 1,000. Now, if that person enrolls someone else, that's your generation two, you get 10% of their base commission. And then you get 5% down the other generations, down to seven generation. There's actually dynamic compression. So if there are people who are not qualified for those, then they compress. So basically, you could get paid on 18 generation down below. I know it happened to us where we got people in our 18th, 20th generation, because there's people who are just not qualified. It just compresses, and we get paid on those generation as if they were our seventh, fourth, whatever. Okay? So that's how this worked for this bonus. And here's an example. So you enroll some people, and those brand partners have earned $5,000 in base commission together in that first generation of yours. That's 15% for you, $750. Those people enrolled others. Again, they're not necessarily placed exactly like that. It could be you that you place people down below, but we consider them your first and second generation. All right, and you can get the picture right here. You know, the more people earn, and as your team grows and you know, mature, your matching bonuses increase over time. All right, and this is every single week. So every week they look at how much your people have earned in base commission. They calculate your matching bonuses based on your qualification, and that's what you earn. Now, business rewards. This is a chance for you to, just like sometimes when you have a credit card and you accumulate points towards all kinds of incentives. Well, this is exactly what we have here with the business rewards, is as you grow your team, your pay line grows, you sponsor new people and new customers into the business, you stay on subscription, you know, you title advance, all kinds of different things that you do normally as you grow your team, you earn reward points. And those help you earn all kinds of incentives, whether it's technology, like sometimes we have cell phones, the new cell phones, the new you know, laptops, or all kinds of different things. But you can also earn trips with the company. And the great thing about the trips is that instead of you having to qualify each year for those trips, you can earn your rewards. So sometimes someone is gonna not qualify for the trip this year, but if you combine the points they accumulate over 1, 2, 3, 4 years, then they earn the trip. All right, then, so these are great incentives. And so, as you know, those trips are always very welcome by anyone in the company. So if you want to go for that, that's another incentive. And the last one, we have loyalty shopping. So every time you spend a dollar with the company, they give you some points that you can use towards rebates on some product. All right, so these are the nine ways that you get paid with our compensation plan, with the PartnerCo compensation plan. Hope this has been helpful, and we'll see you on another video.